Hey, what's up guys, your friendly neighborhood Bujum here, and welcome back to another video. Hope you guys are doing well, and before we get into the source of this video, I'd like to plug my new Discord investing server. The link will be in the description below. I'm going to be hosting some giveaways on there, so make sure you guys join if you want to win. So perusing around a couple of CS investing communities recently, you probably realize there's kind of been a lot of hype for Katowice 2015 stickers. So why do I think Katowice 2015 stickers are a Ponzi scheme? I think to answer this question, we first need to go back and ask ourselves, what is a Ponzi scheme? To find out, let's look at its original founder, Italian-American businessman Charles Ponzi. In the 20s, Mr. Ponzi created a scheme to swindle investors, claiming to have a profitable venture by taking advantage of the exchange rate of stamps. In just a few years, Mr. Ponzi had the equivalent to $6 million to today's money, but he only ever bought $30 worth of stamps. This is because he didn't have a stamp exchange rate scheme. He had what would later be referred to as a Ponzi scheme. Mr. Ponzi would entice investors with high returns.
Oi stranger, boy do I have a deal for you. Just give me $20,000 and I'll give you a 20% return.
Okay, Mr. Ponzi, here's my money.
Mr. Ponzi would then get more investors and use the money that they invest to pay the original investors. And then they would get more investors to pay those investors, and then more investors to pay those investors, and the cycle continues. This process is known as robbing Peter to pay Paul, and is self-sustained until there aren't enough new investors to pump in funds, or the victims of the scheme want out. But how does this relate to Katowice 2015, you might ask? Well, in this case, there isn't one Charles Ponzi. There are many. In fact, one of them commented on my video last week. You've probably seen them blabbering on about how great the potential for Katowice 2015 stickers are because of their low supply and rising prices. But are they right? Well, yes, kinda. Looking at contrary.dev, we can see the supply of many of these stickers aren't exactly the highest, with 300 to 550 for the foils, a few thousand for the holos, and quite a chunk for the papers. And the prices? Well, they've stonked to say the least. Let's just look at the Cloud9 holo, for example. That went from $152 in December to $520 today. That's a 3.4x in just 6 months. What the hell is going on here? In the past 6 months, the supply of these stickers in existence hasn't really shrunk greatly, but the sentiment towards them has shifted massively, as the majority of the demand for these stickers come from people wanting a piece of what they think is the next Kato 14. But how does this make it a Ponzi scheme? Well, think about it like this. Let's just say there are only 1,000 stickers supplied to the market. Somebody says, whoa, 1,000 stickers? That's not many. And he buys 100, thinking one day they'll be nearly extinct and he'll have a monopoly. Now, there are only 900 stickers on the market to be traded. He tells his friends what he's just done, that there's so much potential in these stickers, boys, and four of his friends go and do the same thing, paying a premium to acquire another 400 stickers. Now, there are only 500 stickers to be traded. They make a few Reddit posts, they comment on a few Discords, and people start to see the prices going up. Plenty of new investors jump in, paying a premium on the promise of future reward. Each time a new investor buys in, the more everybody benefits, as not only do new investors contribute to demand for these stickers, they also lower the supply through hoarding the assets in the promise of future return. Remember our good old trusty supply and demand charts? Well, here they are. Let's just say this was the regular point of intersection between supply and demand. Our first investors step in, contributing to the demand by shifting our demand curve to the right. Not only have they shifted the demand though, they've also taken out some of the supply available to the market. So the supply decreases, and our supply curve shifts to the left. This happens again and again as new investors step into the market. Supply shift moves to the left, demand curve moves to the right. Every time this happens, the price gets higher, and the quantity available to the market gets smaller. Okay, so what's my evidence that it is a string of investors who are buying up the market and driving up these prices? Well, my friend, there's a little tool called CSGO Exchange that allows you to see the 200 most recently moved items of any item. Let's do a little search, shall we? How's the Flipside Tactics Holo doing? How about we look at the first 20? These will be the people who just bought these stickers at the current high prices. We see that there's just 9 buyers here, but let's look further into what their sort of inventories entail. The first guy. Yeah, he's an investor. And damn, that's a lot of glove cases he's got there, isn't it? The second? Yep, that's an investor again. What about the last two? Yeah, maybe he's looking to use some of them. But the other guy? Damn, he's hoarding a lot. He's basically a Katowice 2015 whale at this point. Scrolling through these inventories, we begin to see the same pattern. Investor, 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 investor. Everyone who seems to have bought these stickers recently seems to be wanting to have diamond hands and hold onto these stickers to the moon. Each investor paying more and more than the last for a dwindling number of publicly available stickers. And each new investor who comes in, lining the pockets of all the investors who came before them. But does the fact that this is very Ponzi scheme-ish make them bad investments? Not necessarily. Like with a Ponzi scheme, as long as there are enough new greedy investors to buy the stickers, and the people who already own the items, sometimes in their thousands, just hoarding them away, the prices are bound to go higher. Where it really starts to crumble is if the new investment buzz starts to die down, and people start to think to themselves, damn, is it really a good investment if I'm paying 4 times what something was 3 months ago, when those very people who bought the stickers 3 months ago could sell on me at any time? Or those very same buyers 3 months ago, or maybe before, who have a hoard of these items, deciding, prices are pretty high now, maybe it's a good time to sell out, and there not being enough liquidity to keep up the current market prices. What I think is the immediate short-term risk, though, is what I like to refer to as price goes up-ism, where people buy what's going up because it's going up, and they expect it to continue to go up, and by them buying it, it goes up, until they stop buying it, and it goes down. This is exactly what happened twice before for these stickers. As long as everybody has diamond hands, and new buyers are willing to pay higher and higher prices, happy sailing. But as soon as there's a bit of a cooldown, I see the Ponzi scheme having a temporary drop-off. People will lose interest, investors will want to take profits, prices will slump a bit, and because the prices are slipping, we won't have as many new investors coming in chasing those high returns because they see the prices going up and up and up and they think they can jump on the train. Long term, however, I don't think Kato 15 are such a bad bet, as their supply is actually pretty low. To be honest, they're quite nice stickers, but are they really worth 3 times what they were in December? I don't think much except hype and the new investment hoarding has really changed since then, so I'm not really going to be picking up any personally. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, join the Discord, and I'll catch you guys next time.